Hi, welcome to a video tutorial from Robojax. In this video, we are going to learn how to read and write information to MicroSD card using ESP32 and ESP32 extension board from SunFounder's. Let's get started with this. ESP32 starter kit from SunFounder's. This is the best ESP32 learning kit from SunFounder's. It has this ESP32 microcontroller, which has built-in Wi-Fi and Bluetooth. This board can do everything Arduino Uno can do or many other Arduinos can do, plus extra more features. Because we have Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, the possibilities are endless. You can get connected to the cloud or do the control or read information or values via your mobile device or your desktop or over the cloud from a far location. It comes with a camera extension kit where you can stream the video over Wi-Fi either through the cloud or to your network. And also it comes with microSD card where you can save images on the microSD card, or you can write from the device any information, log the information on the device and read it back. You can power the board using this included 18650 lithium battery, and it has built-in charger where you can connect micro USB and charge the battery. The kit comes with 320 pieces of component that you can learn tons of projects. If you purchase the SunFounder's ESP32 learning kit, it comes with this extension board, battery, and my ESP32. And also there is a charge circuitry where it will charge the battery via. So you don't have to worry about charging it and power this device up, and your micro and your ESP32 will be ready. And also we can attach camera here. So in this video, we are just reading and writing file into the microSD card. And in the upcoming videos, we are going to use it, for example, taking photos, saving it, playing music from this microSD card. And perhaps you would use it for data logging, temperature, pressure, whatever you want. The first thing we should know that the capacity for the microSD card cannot exceed 32 gigabytes. So this is the maximum. You can use 1, 2, 8, 4, 16, whatever value you have, but cannot be over 32 gigabytes because we are formatting it with FAT32. Let me connect it to my computer and show you. And here it has been opened. That's my microSD card. Let's see the formatting. Right click and select property. If you have older Windows, click on more option. You will see it like this and click properties. And here it shows file system FAT32. If for any reason this is not file FAT32, right click and select format, or from the long menu, select format. And here make sure from this list, FAT32, and quick format is selected. Click start and accept this warning. The formatting is now completed. Come to this page, docs.sunfounder.com. Scroll down until you see ESP32. Then click on ESP32 Starter Kit Main. On the left side, click on Arduino User. And then scroll down to 7.4, SD card, write and read. This is the documentation page for today's lesson. We are going to use ESP32 board and ESP32 extension board. Just this board with ESP32. And here is the code for today's lesson. We're going to install, we're going to use SDMMC library for this, and there is some explanation. I'm opening Arduino IDE. Let's open our project by clicking on File, Open. On the left side, click on Downloads. then ESP32 starter kit main on the right side, double click to open it, double click on C, double click on codes, and scroll down to 7.4. SD read write, double click to open the folder, select the file, click open to open it. When we installed ESP32, this library have been already installed. Inside the setup, we are defining the serial monitor with 115,200. This is just checking that if SD card MMC begin, it's not true, which means it has failed, then it will print this and it will return. So we will stay on this screen. And then we have this portion which opens this file /test.txt. This is creating a new file. This file says write, and this is the name, and we are creating a handle called file of type file. This, and here we say if the file not, which is true, if the handle has not been created for any reason, then we print this on the screen. So the file can be created automatically. And this line, we say file println. So in the file, in this object that we created using println, we print our text inside that file. And this is also printing it on the screen. So this is printing it in the file, this is printing it on the screen. Else, if it cannot write it, then it will print this text on the screen, and then file.close will close the file. So that was the first thing. After that, we again SDMM open. This means root directory. Open the root directory and create a handle called root of type file. And then here we check if this was not successful, we print an error. Else, this will print on the screen that files found in the root directory. And this while is from here to here, it will run continuously as long as this portion is true. Now let's see what it says. Root open next file. This will check if the next file exists. The result will be true and will be stored in here. A new handle will be created, new object called file of type file. So this is true. If it can see there is a file, then it will print a space, print the file name, file.name will get us the file name, and then this will print a tab with a space, and it will print the file size, and it will close it. Then it will go to the next file, and so forth, until all the files are done, and this will be false, and the loop will exit. Now let's see how we can select the ESP32 board. We can click here, under the select board, and type here ESP32DEV. As soon as you type dev, you see dev board. You can select it and click OK. So the board has been selected. Now we have to select the port. The other way to select the board is click on Tools, Board, ESP32, and select the ESP32 dev module. Now we have to select the port. If I click here, it shows two ports, and I don't know which one belongs to my device. Sometimes you will not see the number properly. So the best way to be sure, the right click on the start menu, go to the device manager, and you will see here the ports. If I click on this arrow, it will show me the ports. One is USB serial CH340, the other is USB serial device. And here, now it's connected. If I disconnect this, one of them disappear. The one that disappeared is my board. So 6 stays and 8 disappeared. If I connect it, so 8 is my COM port, CH340. Now 8 is my COM port and I can select it. Or I can click on Tool, Port, and here you will see it. You can select whichever you want. Ours is COM8. Now we have successfully selected the board and the port. And this is very important. It must be done first. Now make sure the board is connected, everything is ready, let's insert the formatted microSD card to the slot and click to upload the code. Now everything is done. Serial monitor here, everything is ready. If the serial monitor is not open, click here and open it. And make sure that the bit rate for the serial monitor is 115,200. It must match this number, otherwise you will not be able to read the text. Now we press reset so the microSD card or the ESP32 restarts and the serial monitor is already open. Let's press this button. So these are normal information from ESP32, and here file write successful, and then file found, system volume 0, and one file found, and that is called test.txt, and it has 17 characters. Now I'm inserting my microSD card to read it. So let's double click to open it, and here is the test.txt file. Let's double click to open it, and the text that we wrote is in here. Again, and here let's create another file, test2, and let's change the text. Test2 for Robojax, upload the code. This was. Now let's reset the ESP32. And here, when it runs, it found the test with 17 and test 2 with 20. This is our latest, and that was the previous one.